Let's head into this newscast with WION's continuous coverage on coronavirus as the coronavirus outbreak now continues to claim more lives with each passing day. Overnight, the death toll in China rose to 563 with more than 28,000 people reportedly infected. In its daily update, China's National Health Commission announced 73 new deaths. All but three of the casualties were reported in the Hubei province. So far, 1,153 people have been discharged from hospitals after recovering from the infection. As the infection continues to gather momentum, the World Health Organization has made a plea to the world community. The WHO chief has asked for $675 million to help the countries battling the outbreak.
Today, we're launching a strategic preparedness and response plan to support countries to prevent, detect, and diagnose onward transmission. We're requesting $675 million to fund the plan for the next 3 months. $60 million of that is to fund WHO's operations. The rest is for the countries that are especially at risk and who need our support.
Now, in Wuhan, there is a major shortage of hospital beds. Public spaces, including convention centers and stadiums, have been converted into makeshift hospitals to admit more patients. The Wuhan International Exhibition Center, the China Cultural Center and the Hongshan Gymnasium are now taking in patients. They have combined capacity of 4,000 beds. Patients arrived at these makeshift hospitals in three separate buses. Upon their arrival, the patients were directed to a special channel to check for their identity. After the check-in process, the patients were shown to the designated area for further treatment.
Including some from local hospitals, are expected to attend to 1,800 patients suffering from mild coronavirus symptoms, which has a separate function. One is used to examine patients, other provides power.